it's hard to talk about China because we are now engaged, we, and by we I mean the United States, in what is looking more and more like another Cold War. Whereas from 1945 to 1989, we had a Cold War with the Soviet Union. We now, in the last few years, particularly starting with Donald Trump, seem to be heading towards the same kind of Cold War with China. And the reason I mention that is because one of the first casualties of the Cold War with Russia was the end of any possibility of a balanced conversation about the strengths and weaknesses of the Soviet Union relative to those of the United States, and it is becoming increasingly difficult to have that kind of conversation about China, and it's again for the same reason. What's a little different, though, is that in Russia, it was from the beginning a Cold War. With China, yeah, it did start right after the revolution there in 1949, but when Henry Kissinger and Richard Nixon decided to reopen China, I'll put aside what kind of language that is, but when they decided to reestablish political and economic relations with China in the 1970s, there was a radical shift. And China became a friend. China became someone you could talk about. True, they still were communists in the government, and that made a lot of folks leery, but it was clear the United States wanted a very different relationship and got one after the middle 1970s compared to what had happened before. Russia never went through the Soviet Union that kind of an adjustment. Now let's get to those hot-button issues that are now in the news, and I want to comment on the bizarre hot-button issues to show you that they are about the Cold War. They're not really much about anything else. Hong Kong. Hong Kong is not free. Hong Kong is controlled by the central government. That's correct. But let's please remember what Hong Kong was before. It was controlled by a government much further away than Beijing, a government in London. It was a British colony, and it never had independence from Britain for the 99-year lease that China gave to the British, which ended at the end of the last century. And if you wanted an example of what Hong Kong is like, the example might be Puerto Rico, which now has a government that's elected, yeah, but it can't do anything without the approval of a congressional committee that has absolutely nothing to do with Puerto Rico but has the real power. To make a big deal of Hong Kong and to forget Puerto Rico, this is a strange kind of argument, you know. Then there's the Uyghurs, a Muslim minority in one corner of China. I have no idea of how they're being treated. Some of the evidence looks like it's not so good. But for a country like ours that has just finished 20 years of continuous warfare, destroying two Muslim countries at least, Iraq and Afghanistan, not to speak of Syria, Libya, and so on, this is a strange argument to be having breastfeeding considerations for the Uyghurs. South China Sea, the name tells it all. It's their area, not ours. There's no Chinese Navy in the Gulf of Mexico, is there? And then the unfair practices. Oh my goodness. The Chinese gave the American companies a deal. You want to come here, you get cheap labor, you get a growing market, and we in turn get your technology. You don't want the deal? Don't come. You want the deal? Okay, that's the price. Calling that intellectual property theft after the fact, that's kind of dirty pool.